All right, let's do another DHC. So last night slash this morning, depending on where you live, I guess, it was Cooperation Cup, aka the strongest third strike tournament of the year. This was actually the biggest, is what I heard, which is awesome. Just, super top level Street Fighter 3 third strike play in Japan. Team tournament, 5v5. I did a whole DHC on it last time. You really got to go check it out. Before I get into this, just want to shout out twitch.tv/GameNewton, GameNewton. WTON, which is where you can find the stream. The archive is still up there. And there was an English restream, twitch.tv/Nika_KO. NICA_KO. So, anyway, this is going to be Kuroda. Kuroda playing as Q against, I believe, Tominaga as Makoto. Just to make sure. Yes, Tominaga. This was linked to me by Julian Saban, or Saban. Same series as the last one I did with Kuroda, where he just plays like whatever character against whoever. And is awesome, but this is him using Q, which is I think probably the character he's best known for in the US. But like I said last time, not really like his character for real, but just he uses him, he uses Q in the same way he uses like a ton of the cast. So very, very good player. Anyway, we're gonna see in my view the worst matchup in the game. First of all, that was ridiculous. Thanks to Q for having one of the easiest juggled hitboxes in the game. If there's a combo that works on somebody, it works on Q, just about. It's like just a few exceptions. Anyway, tough matchup. Why do I say that? Where to start? So, first of all, Q is a very slow character in a lot of ways, and he's not really built to keep up with somebody with the mobility that Makoto has. So just right off the bat, it's a tough one. Her buttons are excellent. Tough for him to keep up. Her mix-ups are amazing on him. Meaty command grab for her beats wake up. Super. Oh, that was too sick. And even if Q jumps, she can actually recover and parry before he can hit her while he's coming down. Her anti-airs are great. Like she blows up his anti-airs. Like, she just moves anywhere. So when you're playing against Makoto, you have to play I don't know, I don't really know how to put it, in part because I've never figured it out. And in a dozen years, I've never figured out this matchup. It's always terrible for me. I know some Qs don't think it's as bad, but I mean, shout outs to them. I don't know. Like, dude, you can whiff a button as Q. You can press medium kick, and if Makoto is on top of things, she can jump in a way that you can no longer anti-air because you don't have enough frames to do it. Or she can dash and do something, in which case you don't have enough frames to do anything because you just are not fast enough. Like, there are some things. You know that. Makoto wants to do dash up grab. Yep, there it is. Hey, right on time. And as Q, you have an invincible standing up animation. When you're going from crouching to standing, you can't be thrown by ground throws during that time. So you can do super sick things like, duck and then stand. Oh, it just actually might be what Kuroda's doing right now. So you can sort of fight that. You can fight reactively to some degree. If you knock her down, then you play limited Q meaty games. He doesn't really have the best, but you got to do what you got to do. That's really what it comes down to, I think. But anyway, so that's a little bit about the matchup. Let's see how Kuroda approaches it, and surely makes me sound like a dummy because I'm sure he'll win. I'm not sure he'll win, but all the other ones that I've seen, he wins. I haven't watched the end of this thing, so I'm not sure what happens. And as always, when I do these, I'll leave a bunch of time afterward. If it's like not a close match, so that you can, if you can't look down below and see how much time is left and get an idea for who wins. But anyway, Tominaga, first one. Kuroda Q with SA2. Interesting, interesting. We'll see what that's about, I guess.
もうちょっと Q 近づいて、ちょっと引き気味なんでね、なんかしゃがみで聞くとかもっと。
Yeah, you see him ducking right there, but it just, I guess, is at the wrong time. Because it's standing apart, but you gotta get the right time. You see what I mean about him not really having anti-airs? Her jump medium kick is very, very strong. It's just good in general, but other people have, better or faster anti-airs, or they have dragon punches or whatever. Q doesn't have that stuff, so you have to be either at the exact right spot or just block or parry. It's like, which are not the best options. Especially if she mixes it up well with axe kick, which Tominaga does, of course. Oh, that was good. Oh, yeah, I really like the jump. It's weird because I feel like Makoto has... You have to play reactively, like I said. I feel like that's the better way to go as Q. Or just be in... Oh, or just be the best. And react to jump back with Dash Punch Super. That was super sick. So, you know, you can do stuff like that, but I feel like many times it's better to play this matchup a little bit more reactively. Yeah, I mean, you have to be in the right setup and situation in the first place just to even make a game of it, but I don't know. Anyway, that's my own personal thoughts on it. Yeah, so you see how Kuroda did not press a button as he's falling, right? Because he knows that that's parry bait. Oh, wow. He's really trying a lot of seeding DB, the command grab. Capture and deadly blow. Yeah. Yeah, sick. Jump back fierce is an overhead. Well, it's not just on Q, but... Oh, got him. Yeah. Yeah, for full juggle. Full juggle, folks. Stun? Yes. Even Q. Even that big old red... stun bar he has, even that big old long one. Yep. All right. I'll try to temper the salt a bit. He's probably just bathing everybody right now. Yeah, I think you can see Kuroda trying that thing I was talking about with the reaction to dash by crouching. All right, one more mix-up anyway. Yes, that's that. The match can fall apart so quickly. You really got to be on top of things like the whole time. And some of the tools that Q likes to use are not really practical in this matchup. Like some of his good buttons, you know? Buttons that like in a Dudley or Urien match where the opponent can't crouch them. Things like strong, back fear, stuff like that. Or where, you know, if the opponent can't punish slaps on block, sometimes you want to use slaps. It's just that if you use slaps preemptively, Makoto can dash in and punish, or Hayate to punish from, you know, two-thirds, three-quarters screen. So it's not really as practical. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Midi Karakusa, the best. Good tech. Ooh, God. Oh, that was good spacing. Oh, man, a little bit of damage, yes. Yes, Q, the best. Oh, get her. Alright, that was hot. I like that. Need something else, though. Oh, good work. That's a low attack. Crouching fierce. One active frame. Cool, right? It's a cool looking button. But that's Q's life. Super cool looking character. But, you know. Okay, so it works this time. EX, or he's gonna go for the full thing. Yeah, that's right. He did that earlier. Strong dash punch, fierce dash punch. Does not work on everybody. You know, I guess that's maybe a good reason to go for SA2. Typically, I want to keep SA1 where I can so that I have EX meter free and still have super. Because you have two stocks of SA1. Oh, good work. Oh, he's so good at that. But maybe in a matchup where you don't need EX as much, maybe it's you know, cool to have SA2. So I gotta think about that. He's playing so reactively. Oh, man. Look at him just walking away. He doesn't even want to challenge at all. Just waiting for her to do something. Oh, the life. Oh, yeah. Get the little toes. Oh, that was a good fake. Because you know Kuroda was looking for parry there. Oh, just I think that... I'm not sure that was a fake. I'm not sure that was intentional. Just seemed like misplaced. Oh, yeah. Can't get the super combo, but EX is going to be fine. Oh, boy. One more mix-up. Where is it going? Well, I guess if you're Makoto in this situation, there's no need to go totally in, right? Like, the more you... Oh, seriously, wow. That was incredible. I have to, I'm, like, super impressed. I don't know why, because it's Kuroda. But nevertheless, I am. You can really see that Makoto's looking for a dash punch there. She's really looking to parry something. I don't think that's going to happen. Yeah, okay. I just don't see Kuroda bringing that out. Wow, so he won that round three? That game, 3-0. Man. Okay, okay. You know, I mentioned this before, but when I was playing a lot, there were no people playing Q on the Eastern Seaboard in the same way. So I lived in DC for a while, I lived in SoCal for a while, I lived in NorCal for a while, while Third Strike was going on. In NorCal, I was the only Q. In DC, I was the only Q in the whole sort of Central East region. In SoCal, there were a couple, but it was very rare, and the people who played Q were, like, good with other characters, so why bother? And we didn't have as many match videos as nowadays we do, so it was, I didn't really, like, get a lot of time inventing, or I didn't get, oh, that's exactly what I was talking about, right? You see how he did the crouch through her grab, the, like, stand-up animation during her grab? That was so sick. Anyway, the point is just that, the things that I figured out about Q were mostly things I just figured out on my own, and I'm sure that's not optimal in a lot of situations. Like, there were some people, like Streak SRM and SlimX, who made a sick Q video that, like, really helped out. And, you know, we got to see Kuroda and TM and everything every now and then. We just didn't have as many videos. There was less stuff to learn from. So it's always cool to see now that I'm, you know, a little bit more mature in my ability to think about fighting games, to look at videos and see, you know, what I can learn. Honestly, that's a big reason, though, that I do things like this DHC video, where I feel like I think better about it when I'm talking about it, so. Anyway, in the meantime, okay. One more mix-up again. Oh, maybe two. Oh, yes, okay. So if you're not a big Third Strike head, you might be wondering why it is that Makoto doesn't combo into SA2 that much. You can only do so with something like Fierce into Super if she is on the side of the screen that she goes off the wall from. It's really the only place that it works. So if you look at the way that people often tell where they are, is you can see where the clock is, and if you're on the opposite side of the clock from where you go off the wall, then it's not going to combo. Fierce into that is not going to combo. So when she has the opponent cornered, she can't combo into Super in that way, right? But on the other hand, that means that if she is cornered, then you have to worry more about her in some sense than you do if she's cornering you. It's very strange. But cool. It's a cool dynamic. And of course, if she has you cornered, there's plenty of other stuff she can do. She's still very, very dangerous. But man, that, again, good work by Kuroda. He's playing very reactively, but in doing so, he's making a lot of the right decisions. Good timing, just after the crouching medium kick whiffed. Oh, wow. Okay, it worked. He's been looking for it so much. Ah, interesting read. Jump in. I'm sorry, dash in, jump back, roundhouse. Huh. Oh, wow, crazy. I wonder if that was supposed to be dash punch, he just screwed it up. Because he had some charge. Did you actually do parry into dash punch? That is possible. Not that hard. Just waiting. I know the temptation as Makoto, right? Is you want to go in, that's the character. But maybe at this range, you should just hang out. Maybe you just believe, like, look, Kuroda reacts, he's the best. Just take advantage of him in other ways. And you can see Kuroda knows the character he has. It's not really a mobile character. Can't really keep up in footsies. Can't really pressure that well. So it's almost like he'd rather Makoto come in, which is perverse almost. But that's the strength of, you know, the player and the character to some degree. But it's really the player making it work. Oh boy, here comes Super. Yeah. Oh, he screwed it up. That sucks. Kuroda's still in this game. Yo, there's no buttons. Oh, yo, you can link it. Yeah, I wonder if he's trying that. I wonder if he's trying for crouching jab link into super. It's doable. But no, it's too late now. It's too late. Super? Random super? No. Good movement. So that's 3-1, I believe. I'm gonna have to see that again. Just to make sure here. It's like weird to see Kuroda and himself down. Maybe if he switched to red color, it would do better for him. Yeah, 3-1. I mean, red color is the best, obviously. So after Q gets a jump roundhouse, a pretty common mix-up to do is, medium kick into either dash punch or slaps, depending. Oh, he wanted CNDB. Or CNDB. Or just grab. I mean, the low option is, crouching medium kick, which you gotta do every now and then, but you don't get anything out of it. So it's really more about the first two that I mentioned. Because, of course, if the opponent's trying to jump, then they're not going to be able to block the medium kick. Oh, yeah. If it had been jetpack fierce, that would have worked. Oh, that's exactly what I'm talking about. Get it? Yes. And then the old swipe over there after the round end. Nice, nice. I miss being able to press buttons after rounds end. I really wish that Street Fighter would bring that back. And other games too, it's not even just Street Fighter. What? Yo, that was so good. Typically at that range you can't get anything, but I really like that back roundhouse. Yeah, smart play. I'll think about that more. That's good. Oh, juggle. So now you gotta work. Yeah, so you see. Oh, of course. Of course. So why did he not get grabbed? But there you go. Interestingly, you can actually grab him as an air grab out of his, duck transition block. Oh, maybe he was trying to move. Or was he just stuck there? Might have just been stuck there. Yo, she's gotten thrown out of Karakusa a couple of times so far. It just backs off. Oh, it's like it makes sense. You understand why, like how the character works. It's really not that strong at pressure, but it's still sad to see. Oh, that's so good that she can stun like that, man. Even Q, you know what I mean? Like. Alright, so super is basically on deck now for Kuroda. Yes, there it is. You can see him looking for a parry. Tominaga doing the same. And it's really just corner to corner, isn't it? That's so much of this match. Oh, good timing. That was really good. Super late. Axe kick. Again, super late. You know Kuroda's looking for parry. So I guess probably a big reason why he's got SA2. Oh, is that it? Hold on. Juggle, yeah. The big reason why he has SA2 is maybe to get just the juggle after parrying the axe kick. I guess that would make sense. And the meter concerns we talked about earlier. That's cool. Q. Just ducking. Down back. He really hasn't been able to get taunts. Oh yeah, another reason why this matchup is hard is that in some matchups you can get mid-screen, mid-range taunts and it's, you don't get your butt kicked for it. In this one, you get your butt kicked for it. I mean, you get, easiest case, just Hayate, worst case, super, and in between, dash up grab, dash up command grab, all sorts of mean stuff that Makoto can do. So there are very few free taunts. You really have to get like a legit hit first and a legit setup to make a taunt work in this match. Even something, oh, that was really good. Even something like air-to-air fierce, in most matchups, that's a safe taunt. In this matchup, it's not. Oh, missed the axe kick. He's got to go crazy. He's got to go crazy, yeah. He can still do it. He can still do like, oh, okay. Something to look for that always got me mad back in the day, but it sort of made sense, was Makoto dash up super. Something that you see occasionally, and it's because, as we've seen, Kuroda is trying to react to dashes with stuff, with tech, you know, crouch tech, which turns into crouching jab in this game, with buttons like medium kick, with movement like jumps. But if she does super, if she just dashes in and just does super, like, that stuff gets hit, so always infuriating, but it works. Yeah, so, oh, I really like his options. EX, yeah, I like it. Oh, it might have killed. I like the idea. Oh, not over. Not over. Oh, boy, it's totally not over. Yes. Oh, no, you gotta give her the boot. Oh, if you... Look, if I kill somebody with a light attack SQ and they just do the slow falling animation, you gotta give them the boot. It's strange. I almost feel like Kuroda is more comfortable when he is in the corner. Right? Doesn't it feel like that? Like, he knows the penalty for messing up is multiple mix-ups. It's, you know, she has to guess right a few times. Whereas if she's in the corner and she guesses super or whatever, she can get the stun with Kara Fukuyage stuff. Oh, ooh, come on, Kuroda, give me that reaction. Give me that hit confirm, close medium kick. So tough. Ooh. Oh, wow, dash up command grab, that might be it. Okay. Oh, really, wake up? Command grab. That's not, look, to be fair, I do that sometimes too, and it's when I expect that the opponent will be looking for a parry. So maybe that's what he was expecting. Or, you know, maybe the opponent's looking for wake-up super. But something like that. Ooh. Makoto on the slow approach. Slow approach, yes. Oh, she wants the corner for herself, huh? Oh, no, that's it. You're dead. Oh, what?! Maybe he did. He already start the axe kick? Was it too late? I wonder. I just thought he was gonna land and, you know, do fierce super or something. Well, it all worked out for Tominaga. Oh, good slaps. Yes, a free taunt finally. But then you saw a jump medium kick blow up whatever the anti-air was. Taunts, of course. If you're not familiar enough with the game, taunts increase his defense. So that by getting three taunts, you've effectively doubled your life. So it makes him more of a defensive fortress, which is kind of how he plays anyway, so it makes sense. Oh, good work. All right. Save it. I like it. Free taunt, finally. Yeah, there's the mix-up, right? I talked about before. Jump in roundhouse or whatever, then, oh, what's my big stuff? Oh, crouching medium kick. Into nothing. It's even unsafe on hit, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I just looked it up. It's -2 on hit, so shoutouts to you. Crouching forward kick. AKA punishable by Ken SA3. Oh, that was good. You know, it's a close match so far. I described it as being awful. I do think that Kuroda is greatest person on earth. I guess I should amend that by saying, at third strike. But I feel that you can really see how much you have to play game mechanics. That's a thing, right? So in every game, wow, he got a taunt off. In every game, you want to play the game mechanics to some degree, but there are games where the game mechanics are like part of it, not like the whole thing for some characters. In Third Strike, the game mechanics are like 50% at least of playing Q, because the character is just so assed out in so many situations. So you have to just be able to parry, you have to be able to block, you have to be able to know the little weird things like when's he throwing invincible, weird stuff like that. You have to know the opponent's character super well. Oh, that was good. Ooh, the miss, huh? Oh, that was not enraged. Oh, you're a crazy person. I don't like it. I think that could have been better for Tominaga. So I think that part of the reason why Kuroda succeeds as Q is that I think that he's the best, or just about the best, at playing that game engine. Like, that's what I think about when I think about Kuroda. It's not any particular character, it's that he plays Third Strike. In, like, the real sense. Like, it's not like he plays Makoto in Third Strike, or Q in Third Strike. He plays Third Strike. That's the character that he uses. And if the character has any juice on top of that, then fantastic. But if not, that's okay. Overhead, yeah. Oh, I thought he was just gonna do super, huh? Oh, that's so good. That's so good. And then he backs off. Come to me. Oh, it didn't work. Yeah. Anyway, meanwhile, as I'm extolling Kuroda's greatness, he is losing 4-2. The blocks. Oh, the movement. Okay. Good timing. Command grab? Oh, not, okay. It was a really good read by Tominaga. And again, we're in a situation where one more... Oh, he parried first, huh? Dang. How about that? So now he has to worry about Karakusa. Or sorry, SA2. And then he... You can see, it really feels like he's trying to be on the other side of the screen from where she can combo into super. Which makes sense, it just means it puts you into the corner. Tominaga, will he go in? Oh, he does, okay. Good timing. He hasn't been able to not go in. You know, he hasn't... I don't know if he needs to restrain himself, but he certainly hasn't. Let me put it like that. And now there's just defensive fortress Kuroda. Reminds me, I've talked with Justin Wong about playing against Kuroda. You know, you might have seen, if you've been a Third Strike fan, that one time he and Ricky Ortiz went to the USA, SBO, they both lost to Kuroda Q. And I talked with Justin some years after that about Kuroda, and he was like, staring off in the distance, he was like, I've never played anybody who does nothing. And that was it. Yeah, that was like his takeaway from Kuroda, but you understand it, right? Look at how Kuroda plays right now. Just waiting for you to do something. And then taking advantage of it, or trying to when you do. Right now, it's not working out. Oh, wow. Yo, he's looking for the second parry. Yeah, yeah. That was a really good placement by Tominaga. Man, is this gonna be a blow up? I did not expect it. Like I said, I always expect Kuroda to do well, but. Could be not. Oh man, while I'm thinking about it, and speaking of Cooperation Cup, which I will, talk about towards the end of this, did you see Masa Q? He beat Deshiken, he beat Roshi Hikari? Those are two super good players. Deshiken is, I don't really like Ken, but Deshiken Ken is super good. So fun to watch, so strong. Will he get super? Oh, he did! By Pixels, friends! Oh, the hurt. Oh. Oh. Oh, good jump. Good, yeah. Unfortunately, the only way that Q can make the opponent stay still and worry about it is with medium kick into, dash punch if you have charge, or just into raw slaps. And slaps are red parry bait on block, and, you know, even if not, like, many characters can punish them on block, and everybody can punish EX slaps badly. So it's you don't have terribly convincing options. Dang, that's so good. I was just going to say, I will try to do that in the future. And we'll see. I'm sure I'll fail. But you know what? I'll give it the old try. Oh, yeah, right. Looking for the jump. Oh, that was good. Yeah, Tominaga scheming, trying to get back. Jab. Oh! Oh, yeah, I thought he was just going to do super. It's cool, though. Really? What's the first time he's done that? I wonder what that... Like, what's the... It's the new tech of crouching short. What's this about, friend? No. Yeah. Maybe just hoping that Tominaga runs into it. And I just think it's strange that he started doing this in the 8th game. Oh, okay. Dash up. Grab. Again, two more mix-ups. Oh, that's the second. What's the third? What's the third? Oh, killer. Killer. Into the corner. God, her jump attacks are so good. And how many times have we seen this exact range? Oh, wow. First time dash up. Fukiage, just like that. Okay. Kuroda's not out of this thing. He's got to wait for that red to go down a little bit if he can. It's going to be tough. Oh, I like it. That was good. Oh, again, he did it! Yeah, kept it simpler. It's a little bit tough to time the dash punch follow-up. It's not the worst. But certainly much easier to do that if you're near the corner. Or you can even just press Fierce, the Fierce button, and you'll zombie right into them. If you're close enough to the corner. Good timing. I really like how he mixed up with forward strong and just was like hiding the movement a little bit better than he had been. Wow! Oh, okay. Okay. I guess he thought it would kill. But it did not. So, 5-2, tied 2-2. Again. Oh, that movement was ridiculous. Oh, that. It's almost stunned. Next hit is going to be stunned. Oh, I like the read, but. And in fact, even Kuroda was in the air. Crazy. That was good. Taunted up, yes. Yeah, there's those slaps. So now they both have super locked, and you can see Kuroda's looking for that. He really wants, yeah. See, it's good block by Tominaga, recognizing that's what the opponent wants. And Tominaga's still going in. I thought he might just wait. Does not seem like his MO. Oh, that should be it. No, it could have just supered. Or EX slapped even. Wow, he could lose. Oh, that might have worked. It did. Okay. I think Tominaga was in the air. It looked like he jumped just before then, so he might have tried, like, jump into instant forward parry. But maybe not quite there. I don't know. So, was it 5-3? Okay, Kuroda making a game of this thing. That was good. That's a taunt. Maybe two taunts even. No, okay. Oh, that was good. That was so good. This has got to be a taunt as well. Okay, so now he... Oh, man. This is Kuroda. Yo, if Kuroda loses this round, that's going to be a heartbreaker. Makoto has to go wild to make this work. Okay. No super, I don't think. Yeah. Too far. Good block. Oh, that's it. Nice parry. That's just one of those sort of option select mid-range parries. If it works, it works, but you just sort of, you press down then crouching short rather than just crouching short. And that way you'll parry if the opponent does something low. Again! Oh, that's such a good tool. Yeah, oh, I totally agree with that. Get the two taunts rather than a little bit more damage into the taunt, into one taunt. I think that was definitely the right call. Because now you see how much damage that throw did? Look at this. Very, very much less. It's just, you know, the nature of the matchup is it's tough to get parries. It's tough to get taunts. So good call. Here's Kuroda. Let's do this. Crap, yeah. Very, very common to try that. Although I think it might be the first time he's done it. He's faked it a lot. Good work. Let's see what he gets, Tominaga! Oh. Might be death. No, okay, okay. Yeah. It's a dangerous game that Kuroda plays, of the sort of reacting, put yourself in the corner style. Again, part of it is just because of the character, but it also seems like what he likes to do with the character. You'll see some Qs who are a little bit more active than he is. But when it goes wrong, it goes super wrong. That was good. You know, knowing that, I wonder why Tominaga still goes with Super 2 in this matchup rather than Super 1. Knowing that Kuroda likes to not let her be in the corner herself. I don't know. Pretty tough for him to beat her buttons, that's for sure, in the air. Well, anywhere. Oh boy. Tominaga fighting back. That was so good. Is he gonna dash up? You know he's gonna dash up. Oh, he didn't. Okay, okay. Man, so many of these games have been close. There have been a few 3-0s. But even Kuroda had one of those, so that's not... even the ones that have been blow-ups, they've like both had blow-ups. We've seen that so many times. Tominaga at that range, half screen. And what's he going to do? And Kuroda just has to react. Oh yeah, so important to jump there. Okay, okay. Kuroda Fortress. Oh wow, that was super weird. I wonder if that was even intentional, honestly. So now life lead for Tominaga. Keeps going in. I wonder what this matchup would look like if he just played defense. Not defense, really, but maybe more mid-rangey stuff. It's not really Makoto's strength, but then there's no challenge, really, from Kuroda. Oh, God. Are you serious? Why would you do that? I don't get it. Oh, that's too... Come on. Why wouldn't he just do the fierce dash punch? I don't understand that at all. I mean, he ended up taking the game, but... Oh, wait, hold on. It was anti-air? Oh, okay. Alright, she's already in. Tominaga already doing work. Good tech. You know, of course, the last one that I did of this, last DHC, it was Kuroda himself playing Makoto, so he knows all about the dashing. All about the canceling of dashes with grabs and how important that is. He knows all the characters. He's played this game. Looking for a dash punch follow-up, the Hayate. Oh, that's good, that's good, yeah. Okay. Kuroda, working on evening it up here. Corner control, Tominaga. You know, maybe corner control is the wrong word. It's just... Because from Kuroda's perspective, it feels like he doesn't mind putting himself there. It feels like he's just playing reactively anyway. Yeah, good work. And it's not so much that it's like... So typically when I think of corner control, I think of somebody who picks a spot and plants themselves, and they're just like, okay, you're not getting out of this corner. That's not really Tominaga's style. It's to be at this, you know, about dash range, about the range where you can cancel your dash into whatever for Makoto. and then do something. Go in. It's not so much just hang there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. There's one. Okay, where's he going? Yeah. That's good. That's really good. Not hit confirm. Yeah, he could not go for two. That would not have been safe at all. Just like that, we are back into the corner. Okay. Wow, dashing, huh? Those might be the first two dashes we've seen from Kuroda in neutral game. All of a sudden, he's getting a little bit of mobility over there. Yeah, look at this. Interesting. I mean, he is down in life, but that hasn't really stopped him from laming it out before. So the end of that round there makes me really think about what I was talking about before. Would it be worthwhile for Tominaga to not just go in, to play that more, you know, can't really call it defensive, maybe run away, maybe just being active, but not by going in all the time? Because at the end of that round, that looked pretty tough for Kuroda to deal with. Whereas Kuroda seems much more at home, just waiting to react to something. Yeah, I really disagree with that command grab try. You know, first on Kuroda's mind is don't be where she can get into super. Like, do not get command grab there for sure. Nah. She can still take this, actually. Yeah, okay, there you go. And she doesn't really have hit confirm into super with SA2, other than Karakusa. Oh, maybe like just like jump in, whatever, fierce, whatever. But other than those two, it's like she has to just bet on a fierce super. Nice. And you have to believe that sometimes, but in general, I really agree with Kuroda's idea of just jumping away. Just, you know, make the opponent take something super risky like that. In the meantime, now that he has three taunts, look at how much damage Makoto does. That might have worked. Yeah, I like that one. That's tricky. Oh god, that's so insane. The taunts don't help his stun bar out. You know, he can realistically get stunned twice. That is totally possible right now. It's happened to me. Oh god, he lost the round where he got three taunts. Man, that sucks. And that would have been for the tie too, instead of 6-4. I like the walk back taunt. That's a good start. Okay. You know what? That makes a lot of sense, actually, because Kuroda has parried a lot in that situation. So he's looking for things like short into Hayate. So I really like that command grab. I think that was really smart. Cool. Always cool to see little adaptations like that during a set. Oh, that was so good. He delayed that fierce just a little bit. And then you see he whiffed the crouching jab. Very common to time the fierce dash punch with that crouching jab first. You sort of just, you do the super, you mash crouching jab, and as soon as crouching jab is over, you do fierce dash punch. Oh, he could have done super there. Okay, oh wow, too late on the command grab. Oh no, it all went wrong. Yeah, no tricky Karafukiage required. Just the easy stuff. Just get the kill. Really? Hmm. Really, back strong, looking for a jump, I guess. It has come. Dash up neutral jump has come on quite a bit from Tominaga. Alright, alright. Oh, that's... Oh. That had just been roundhouse, that would have been it. Okay, there you go. There you go, there's a punish. So there's the timing again. Yeah, it's time to go in. There's, at this point... Oh, that was so good. Nice. At that point, there's no point in having a taunt. Like, you're gonna die in one or two hits anyway. It doesn't... It's not gonna give you enough. So, might as well just go in. That was a good call. Alright, Tominaga needs one more mix-up after this. Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, that was good, that's good. That might be it. That was a good round, no doubt about that. Oh, really? Again? Do it again? Oh! Oh, this is the vortex now. Dude, oh, well, he's got stunned. Super, oh man, this might be it. Yeah, oh wow. What a ridiculous couple of rounds. VPP. So now it's 7-4, I think. Kuroda almost tied it up. If you recall, it was... Last round, 4-5-5 or 6-4, and it was 6-4, so, but it was close. And now we got 7-4, so I mean, the point is, Kuroda can do this. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Save it. There you go. Yeah, and just like that, back into the corner. So now... Oh, that's a... It seemed like reaction. Oh, this might be it, actually. Yes. There's the super. Yo, you guys. She does so much damage and stun. Oh, that was really good timing. He might take this. Ooh, it's gonna be close. Oh, no, it's gonna be... Yeah. Not gonna be close after all. It's gonna be for sure. So he faked going in that time. You can see Q doesn't really get that much after a grab. If the opponent rolls after a grab, it's not super valuable for him. Okay, good block, good block. Little late. Oh, he tried the red parry, yeah. Like I said, it is kind of red parry bait. If the opponent is good at red parries, like you really don't want to use slaps very often. It's just it's risky. Nice. It's too bad. I always wanted slaps to be more legit in neutral, but you know that's the breaks. Oh, that was I really like the parry attempt right there by Kuroda. Oh, there you go. Okay, that's a lot of damage. That's a free taunt. Just like that, though. I mean, we've already seen rounds where he loses and he's been up on three taunts, so it's doable. Nice parry. Oh, beautiful. What a cool set of counter adaptations there. We've seen the jump from Kuroda out of a throw, then it turned into anti-air Fukuyage in that situation, then it turned into anti-air Fukuyage but parry. So I wonder what the next one's going to be. Maybe like anti-air, wait for Karakusa. Oh, yo, he linked it for real. Give me that. Is that four? Oh, he's just going to do this. Three. Okay. Good stuff. Yeah, it would have been four if he did the fierce dash punches, which is what I was looking for. Yeah, that's a punish. I feel like Tominaga is getting a little bit off the rails right now. I feel like he should just settle it down a little bit. I mean, you have to go in at this point, but I mean... I don't know. It seems like he's picking some bad times. Yeah, I really don't like the command grab. Okay, that was a good one, though. Well, to be fair, I don't know if I would like that either, but hey, it worked, which is the important point. Oh, no killer. Oh, boy. One more mix-up. Oh, so late. Oh. Oh, no Fukiage, no parry even. Oh, that was such a well-timed dash-up grab. Got him. Got him. Oh, wow! The chip! Are you serious? Oh, boy. Oh, man. That's... Whenever that works, you always feel like a genius. Because it works... Well, actually, its success rate is not bad. You bring it out so rarely. But you really have to have a read that the opponent is looking for something stupid on wake up from you. You know, something like a button or an EX slappy slaps, which is not invincible, but it's pretty fast, or wake up super or something like that. Okay. He's gonna save the meter. Oh no, he missed it. Pretty tight timing. Alright, well that said, Tominaga has the corner again, tried to get the juggle too far. And he just really cannot punish her as he's landing from the jump. You don't have enough time, so. It's always an extra mix-up. The mix-up as you're waking up, and then if she did command grab, the mix-up as you're coming back down from the jump. Oh wow, genius. That was good. He makes good use of that. Gonna get a taunt going on and then just backing away, getting away from the corner. Taunt again. Man, he's looking good. Oh, this might be in range for super. Is he gonna try it? No, okay. Maybe just a few pixels to the right. Too far to the right. Oh boy, yeah, I was gonna say, I didn't have enough time to get it out first, you know? But I was gonna say, I hope he doesn't do jump back fierce, because I really think that's what Kuroda's looking for. Okay, the pressure. Man, Kuroda's really trying to make this comeback right now. Not gonna even it up if he wins this round, but 7-6, he's gonna keep this thing close. Oh, nice. Oh no, yeah, that was not the right spot to do that, that's for sure. And very well punished. Very well punished by Kuroda. So 7-6, keeping it alive, huh? Q dreams. Yet remain. Well, let's see if you can keep it going. It does feel like Tominaga has been making some less than effective decisions in terms of just some of the mix-ups that he's brought, but it's just, I guess it's rare to be punished as well as Kuroda punishes things. Like, it's rare to get busted for trying jump back fierce and whiffing it. But look, you have to see your opponents doing that stuff. Very nice. And adapt to it. Now, you're not playing by yourself here, you're playing against somebody else. Okay. See where he goes from here. Okay. Need something else still. Oh, yeah, that was really good, that was really good. That was exactly the range where you would do command grab. And where things like jump back fierce don't work anymore, because you gotta just start from point blank. So, that felt like if I were Kuroda, I would be expecting that to have been another command grab. So, anyway, here's super. He started out with a little bit of red on that bar, so he might try for the stun. Yeah, not quite. Okay. Oh yeah, he just reacted to that. You see that? He just put himself at a range where he could react. That was really good. Jump back. Oh, okay. Interesting. Wake up, back strong. The only time I've ever done wake up back strong is when my opponent, when I think that my opponent is looking for me to do wake up super, and I'm looking for them to jump, which maybe was what Kuroda was thinking about, I don't know. So again, Kuroda, with a chance to tie it up, he needs to win one more round, but like that's... It's either 7-7 or 8-6, and that's a big swing at this stage. First to 10. Very haphazard play right now. Nice jump jab. Oh man, Kuroda's game is on point right now, that's for sure. He's reacting with all the right things. Even when he has to block, like he's reacting with a block. Oh boy, no, you can't. You couldn't do anything about it. Couldn't do anything about it there. Still another chance though. Oh, again. I mean, I don't think that was a punish there. It might have been a late command grab, and that might have allowed the jump fierce to hit. I'm not sure. That would have been on the very margins either way, but it could have been that Tominaga was just looking for something else. Like maybe he was trying to jump or do another command grab or something. We'll never know. Oh man, you see how fast Tominaga's trying to play right now? He's trying to play super fast. Does not want to give any time to think. Oh, he just got the bar. He can even it up. Next hit. Either way, really. Oh, jumping back. Oh, that sucks. Oh, Kuroda. Oh, man. That was such a hard-fought game. That was so hard-fought. Well, it's not over. It's not over. It's first to 10. I like how Tominaga really tried to speed it up. It worked. Nice control. Well, again, maybe not so much control is the right word, but good corner mix-ups. Okay. Will he go for super? I don't know. Yeah. I think that's the better call. Oh, that might have worked. Yes. Alright. Ooh. Oh, that's it. No, he had to just get a super. So this is the slower kind of game. Oh, I was just going to say. It's the slower kind of game that I think Kuroda would rather play. But that's assuming that he can react to everything. And you know what? He reacts to a lot of stuff. But it's tough to react to everything. Oh, good. Yeah, I like it. Alright, so... Oh, good timing on the Fierces. He hasn't had too many jump Fierces. Yeah, I tried it again, getting a little greedy. Alright, Tominaga's still in there though. Boy, we really haven't seen too many neutral stand medium kicks, have we? It's just not a matchup where you get to use footsies in that sort of way very often. Alright, so he does stay in. Oh, that might be the first time. Or if not, there's just been a couple of times where he hasn't like immediately moved away from the corner. So you can see him falling with a lot of buttons now after a command grab. That's something that Tominaga has to look for. Because it's more than just one. You know, it's happened a few times. And Tominaga can blow that up. But I always thought it was weird that Makoto can try command grab with zero repercussions as Q gets up. Because like I said, it grabs super. That's Q's only invincible option. Other than that, it's just, it's like jump, which, again, Q can't punish from anyway, so there's no reason not to do it, other than you're looking for other sorts of damage. Oh, that sucks that he missed it. Well, it all worked out. It's like, if you were a computer, you would just always do, meaty command grab, because it's safe. There's no reason not to, other than you would want to do more damage in some other ways, and maybe you would just do command grab and then play the mix-up, because it still feels like it's okay for her. But, you know, in reality, it doesn't work like that. I always thought it would be funny if you, like, gave the computer a set of instructions and one of them was like, hey, this one has zero downsides, other than opportunity costs. Like, I'll just always do this. But, you know, again, that's not humans. So anyway, it's 9-6. Which means not looking great for Kuroda. And certainly he has played this well. You know, I feel like he's really milked a lot of milk out of the old stone here. What is that phrase? Get juice out of a stone, whatever. Anyway, Q sucks. You get the point. He parried and then jumped out of slap. So go. Oh, that's it. Oh, unless there's the screw up. Oh boy. Oh, that was, yes, that was so good. Kuroda takes advantage. But that could have been Tominaga's game. Could have been his round, I should say. Nice play. Tominaga in. Oh, yeah, again. Like, it's almost always, I feel, worthwhile to jump out of that situation. Even if you get hit sometimes as the Q. Like, unless it's very consistently happening. It's, I don't know. You just don't want to get hit by her super. It's just, that's super important. Okay, Tominaga. Oh, he looked like he was backing off, but no. Okay. Will he stay in? He did. Oh, that was that. No, it wasn't the first time, but that's just a couple of times. Oh, the red pair. Oh, God, he's a genius. Amazing. The red parry, even. Because he was at risk for chip. I don't know if it would have happened. But it was at risk, that's for sure. Oh yeah, good work. The timing, the taunt. Yeah, you see him trying to move away. I really like the crouching medium kick as a result. I thought that was good. Just expecting Kuroda to move. So now, oh, and he pressed a button. You know what? Honestly, if I were Tominaga there, I would also have gotten up, you know, dashing or whatever that was. It wasn't wake up super. It wasn't something like that. That looked like a dash or a jump. I 100% I would have looked for Kuroda to move away. So that, I think that was a really smart call, but extra super smart by Kuroda. He had the reads. Okay, so Tominaga has the corner, but that's really been about 60% of this match. Tominaga has the corner. Yo, he's going in more. This is something that Tominaga has to recognize. Okay. Oh, he messed it up. Oh boy, that means he doesn't get super. It means he doesn't get corner. It means he doesn't get taunt. All sorts of stuff. That was a big miss. Reversal. Huh. Interesting. Okay, so Tominaga has the corner. Okay, now, is he gonna stay in? Yeah, look, Tominaga, come on, buddy. I mean, maybe you don't want to take big risks right now because Q has SA2 on deck, but I don't know, I feel like that's something he's gotta get a read on. That jump cancel, that was real smart. So, taunt. Ah, there's the patience. Ooh, no link. Oh, Tominaga threatening, scheming. He's gonna dash up at some point. It's just like, when is he gonna do it? Oh no! Okay, Kuroda! We haven't seen those things out of him. Dash punches just like that. It's weird. There are these rounds where all of a sudden Kuroda, like, remembers something, and he's like, oh, I should, you know, I haven't done a dash punch in a while. Or remember when he was doing dashes all of a sudden, or he was doing, like, medium kicks all of a sudden? And then he goes back to not doing it for, like, the next three games. I don't know, that's... it's very hard to get a beat on somebody like that. Oh, boy, he went in again. Again, yo, Tominaga. You gotta see this. You gotta see this. Because if you keep letting... Oh, that's it. Yeah. If you keep letting Kuroda pressure you like that, like, he's threatening the comeback already. Oh, boy. Okay, so this is super. He's going to try for the Kara. He's going to try for the stun. Yes, he got it. And he's going to do it again. No? Oh, okay. Yeah. So you can't re-stun in that situation, but you can sure get a ton of damage. Yeah, that was a good round. And he even has another super. Look at that. Okay. Devastating round. But just like that, Tominaga back in. Too far for the juggle. Oh, God. Caught the landing. So one more mix-up now. Oh, yeah, he got it. Good work. You can really see... you can see Kuroda's Q, like, wiggling right there. That's Kuroda really trying to mash. But not enough time. It's very common for Qs, especially at lower level, to do air-to-air fierce, then fierce dash punch to get right back in. And everybody looks for the parry there, so that's why you see Qs do something like jab or strong dash punch, just to move forward relatively safely and to, like, fake the parry, you know. Oh, yo, he's jumped out of that every time. So, okay, now it's 9-8. Kuroda is making this comeback right now. He's working on this. I mean, look, shoutouts to Kuroda for consistently guessing right in that sort of situation where all of a sudden Tominaga has the corner and all of a sudden, you know, it's a reset situation, what do you do? And it feels like Kuroda has jumped out of it correctly almost every time. Okay, good damage, good corner carry. You know, the corner carry not so important for his offense, it's that he's fighting a little bit as he's moving backwards, putting himself into the corner. So the more time he can spend in that fight would be better for him. Oh, there you go. Oh, it was enough. Oh man, Kuroda. He's steaming. He's moving in. Nice tech. Oh god, nice tech again. Oh yeah, he went for overhead dash punch? He believes in himself right now, that's all you can say about that. Yeah, look how much more he's fighting. Right, there were many, many rounds, many games where he just backed off and he just would, like, wait until the opponent got close and whatever. But, wow, he's really, in this round, okay, he's getting his butt kicked right now. But earlier in that round, he was doing a lot more fighting. Tominaga has been on match game for, like, three games in a row now? No, maybe this is the fourth. I think it was 9-6 at one point, wasn't it, right? Oh, man. This could be... Oh, boy. Oh, boy. What do you do? Oh, good berry. Still, though, there's so much red. Any hit. Okay, one more mix-up. Oh, wasn't enough. Okay, yeah, I really like that. Just taunt. You couldn't get in there in time, so just do what you can do. Oh. Oh, man. Tominaga. I don't know how Q's going to make this comeback. Oh, that could be it. Oh, he went for grab there? Okay, he might go in. He did. Oh, too far, but not killed. Oh, Tominaga. Yo. Oh, that needed to be punished. Oh, boy. Oh boy. That right there makes me think that Kuroda is gonna make this full comeback. That brain fart right there by Tominaga. challenges, so many more challenges. Yeah. Okay, yeah, he saw it, he saw it. Get the good damage, get the taunt. Only sweep, yo. He is not getting big damage punishes. Like, if Q whiffs C and DB, he is out there. Okay, okay. So one more mix-up, and it's gonna be the round. Just depends on what the mix-up is. Alright, so we're on match point now for Tominaga, assuming he doesn't screw this up so badly. Okay. Okay. What do we got? Let's see. Come on. Let's go. Tominaga threatening. Oh, boy. Wow, very late axe kick. Interesting. Oh, I don't think he... Well, I'm not sure. I don't think he meant to do that, but who knows? In any case, it worked out for Kuroda. Okay, so Tominaga here. Ooh. Yeah, very late. I love the lateness of that medium kick. Great block by Tominaga. Oh, very tense. They know neither one wants to make the big mistake. You can see Kuroda really trying to... He's moving more. You see him jumping a lot more. Challenging a lot more. It's a little bit of a different style than he's had in other rounds, so Tominaga's gonna have to see that. And to his credit right now, Tominaga not going in, not overextending. Oh, what? He didn't do anything? Oh god, that could be it. That might have been the big chance. He wouldn't have taken the game, but it would have been, you know, he would have had a much better situation than right now. Oh, and then not there either? I really thought it was just gonna be super cool. Oh. Yeah, I love the try. For the hit confirm. I don't know, can Kuroda do this? He has 9 seconds. I don't know. Oh my god. Yo. Oh, he got it. He got it. Oh. We're going to the final game. I can't believe it. He made that full. Yo, he was down 9-6, I think. Was it 9-7? It was one of those. Oh my god. Final game, man. As Q versus Makoto. Wow. I wonder how Kuroda will play in this one. Will it be back to the very slow, reactive play, or will he be more mobile as he was in the last game? Pretty reactive so far. Pretty slow so far. But the fact that he does mix it up like that makes it, I think, a little tougher for Tominaga to know what to do. Definitely reactive so far. Oh, no, he's trying. Okay, never mind. Oh, wow. Everybody tries to parry there just in case. It's one of those things that's it's almost a costless parry. To just press toward as you're waking up after the reset. If the crew did dash punch, great. If not, you don't lose much. So, okay. Does he stay in this time? No. Although he did backdash, and that might have been super-able. Okay. Is that it? Yes. Oh, wow. We're even tight on rounds right now. Let's go, Kuroda. Okay. Oh, wow. EX just like that. Tominaga with a nice reaction. Jump roundhouse. I like this. Okay, good movement. He's keeping himself unpredictable, but ugh, just as I say that, there's fierce slaps which should have to be predicted. Not really reacted. Okay, so now Super's on deck. So I'm not gonna maybe a little has to be a little bit more cautious. Oh, he went and he jumped in. Wow. Yeah, definitely Q does not want to be right there right now. He does not want to be on that side of the screen. But Tominaga just moving. Moving around well. So it's not the super reactive style right now. The first round it seemed like it was. Or maybe it was the second round. In any case, one of the rounds it was. Right now, no. Right now he's doing stuff. I mean, he's doing stuff as Q, so he's not like, you know, he's not a maniac. But there are more buttons. There's more air buttons. No, he did it! Oh my god, dash? That was ridiculous. And then he challenged. Oh my god. Oh, he's about to match point. I can't believe he's at match point right now. He won three games in a row all of a sudden. Okay. Oh no. Tominaga. Is he falling apart? Yep. Challenging. Okay, okay. Looking good. Looking good. Parry. Oh, he tried it. He tried the parry. If he had gotten that parry, that would have been Fierce Super. That would have been end of the round. But as is, this is definitely match point. This is, any hit could be SA2. Could be the set. Oh, he's moving in as Q. Oh. No dash. Oh, I was just going to say, no dash punch coming. There it was. Tominaga threatening. Does he risk dash up grab? Does he risk it right now? You can see how scared he is. His movement is so different than it was earlier in this match. So different. Oh, that's a big risk. Not pun. Oh, is that it? Boy. Final round. Final round. Crazy. Yes, there's a taunt. AKA more life. Higher defense. Hey, look at the movement on Tominaga's side. So much more tentative. Oh, what? What a read. Okay, this is all Q right now. This is a tougher comeback, especially given how Tominaga's playing right now, especially how much less he goes. Oh, my heart stopped. That was not super. Where was the super? Where was the super? Oh boy, Kuroda. He stayed put. Oh man. This could be the train. Oh, he missed it. Oh, these guys are cracking. They're both. Both of them. Oh, the speed. He got the stun. He needs more. He needs that. That extra life is still up. No! Oh no! All of that work. All those games on the comeback. And then at the very end, is that the only wake-up super of the set? No, I guess there was maybe one other that I can think of, but even still, what a read. I mean, gutsy read by Kuroda, that was it. Either way, he knew. You know, that's the kind of thing and the kind of situation where you're just going to let it hang out, and if it works, fantastic, and if not, that's it, GG. And it was GG. What a set. Still, though, fantastic play by both players. I still think it's a terrible matchup, and I'm very impressed by how Kuroda handled it for long parts of that. I thought were super impressive. The way that he mixed it up between being very, very slow, patient, reactive, and being, you know, again, you're never a crazy guy as Q, but there were times when he pressed more buttons. He pressed more, you know, he had slaps anti-airs, which you do preemptively. He had jump-ins sometimes. You had buttons sometimes. He had meaty command grabs sometimes. So he mixed it up between both of those styles. And, I mean, not that he did the second very often, which was probably the better call. So, but I love how he did, you know, dash punch super on reaction to jump back fierce or whatever from Makoto. That's a super important tool. And you could see a lot of the usage that he made out of just the third strike system of parrying axe kick, parrying, you know, crouching short Hayate, stuff like that. But. Man, super good set. That was awesome. How long was that? Jeez, I didn't even realize the time passed. That was very long. I guess no real need to make the recording any longer than it has to be, right? It went the full distance. So, dang, that was ridiculous. Well, hope you enjoyed that one. That was sent to me by again Julian Saban or Saban. On Twitter, Man. Great set. Shout out to Tominaga. Played super well too. Anyway, mentioned briefly before about Cooperation Cup. Again, I highly recommend checking it out. You can find the archive at twitch.tv/GameNewton. GameNewton. I'll put the link down below. And This Is Third Strike, run by Nika KO, also put up an English restream of it, which you can find at twitch.tv/Nika_KO. NICA_KO. You know, if you want to get that. Awesome play. There was a Q who figured in it, which, yay, that was cool. And, you know, just the end was awesome. All was tons of great players. Very highly recommended. And in addition to that, I just wanted to plug Fightcade on PC, which you can play a bunch of old games on, including Third Strike. And also on console, you can play Third Strike as Third Strike Online Edition. You'll hear some people ragging on it. It is a, you know, it's not quite the same as the arcade, but who cares? You're playing Third Strike. It's, you know, if you're a purist about it, I get it. But it's, if you just want to try the game out, then I really recommend it. And, you know, give me a tweet or something. If you're gonna, happy to help out. And you'll find jerks on Fightcade, but you'll also find a bunch of very nice people who are happy to hang out, happy to help you out. So anyway, that was fun. Shout out to Tominaga. Played well. See you, everybody.